Moving on to more tales of dystopian Britain, I want to know who thinks it's a good idea to charge people criminally, children no less, with name calling. You know, there's a lot of people talked about this. When Count Dankula got criminally charged for teaching his pug how to do Nazi salutes for what was clearly a comedy video. And just in case anyone doesn't think it was clearly a comedy video, here is 10 seconds of it just to illustrate the point.
I'm not a racist, by the way. I just really, really wanted to f*** on off.
Jews.
To me, it's the very definition of insanity to see a man like that charged criminally. It was a piss take. Humour. And it's just got worse since then. I think Scotland is the worst in all of the UK, by the way. Now, you've got to expect that with the fucking SNP, who couldn't run a fucking piss up in a brewery. But they just seem to be the most alarmingly authoritarian of everyone in the UK. And to see a 12-year-old kid get charged for racist chants just doesn't sit well with me. It doesn't mean that you're anyone with any fucking sense supports being a racist prick, because that in itself is illogical and disturbing on a dozen different levels, but it's fucking name calling, and every free person has the right to be a fucking dick. Like, essentially calling people names should never be criminalized. I don't get it. Like, where we decide to take offense is down to the individual. And if you just arbitrarily write a name and draw a line in the sand and say, oh yeah, well, calling someone a fat cunt is not acceptable, but it's not criminal. But calling someone a racial slur is criminal, then it's arbitrary where we move that line. Eventually they're going to say, oh yeah, well, actually, now you mention it, calling some 600-pound fucking saggy fucking mess a fat fuck, that's offensive as well. It's just as offensive as calling a black person a racial slur. Okay, then let's criminalise that. It's a slippery fucking slope. The fact of the matter is, it is so arbitrary as to be authoritarian if you start locking people up for being a prick to people. Every freeborn man or woman has the right to be a fucking arsehole if they're having a bad day. And if you want to get on the bus and you accidentally knock into someone and you go, oh, fucking get out of my way, you daft, fat, spotty, goofy, whatever you want to call them, ginger bastard, you shouldn't be getting nicked for it. I think the UK lags behind the United States in a dozen different ways with this type of thing. But the idea that little kids, children, are getting criminally charged for being a prick to a footballer is unfucking believable. And I think it's completely unacceptable. But you tell me, why is calling someone a racial slur that much worse than calling them anything else? I remember Jordan Peterson once saying, would you rather be dumb, fat, short, poor and stupid and white in America? Or tall, handsome, good-looking, wealthy and well-educated and black? I think we all know what the answer is. So if you happen to be quite a confident, successful black person and someone calls you the N-bomb, for example, probably going to be nowhere near as offensive as if you're a total fucking loser, physically repulsive person with nothing in your life at all that brings you any joy because you're just fucking deadbeat. If someone starts mocking you about your physical characteristics, if you are a little fat, ugly ginger midget and you're homeless and you've got nothing and your wife left you and your kids hate you and you've got nothing, I think someone mocking you about being a little fat, ugly, homeless midget is going to upset you a lot more than calling someone wealthy and educated and successful the N-bomb. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe if someone's from a minority group, please tell me. I'm just a privileged white man. What the fuck do I know? But this is just yet another example of Scotland being fucking Scottish. You can see why they joined the Union, because they went bankrupt. Because these useless cunts are the worst of the worst. Out of the whole of the UK, the Scots are the fucking biggest maniacs when it comes to creeping authoritarianism. They just lap it up. And Dankula apparently now votes for the SNP, which is essentially a Marxist party. Owen Paterson thinks so. And he probably knows more about politics than fucking most. There's tons of their politics I can't fucking understand. And yet they're universally popular in Scotland. So, yeah, who the fuck knows what's going on up there? point I'm making is I could find dozens of other alarming incidents of this shit north of the border. We had that famous one of the police monitoring your tweets. I remember that one. Where that's a 19-year-old kid lad who got arrested for making a shit joke about an out-of-control bin wagon. And they tweeted that out. Please be aware that we will continue to monitor comments on social media and any offensive comments will be investigated. If you're Scottish, tell me what's going on. What about that fills you with pride and goes, I fucking love Scotland. It's fucking great. It's not great, it's fucking shit. And it will inevitably lead to creeping authoritarianism. The slippery slope of, well, this is banned and that's banned. Fuck it, ban all the things. Humour. You've already banned humour. Count Dankula will tell you that. Now you're going down the road of 12-year-old lads being rude. Fucking bang the wee cunt up. I don't know what the solution is, because they fucking hate the Tories up there. Well, even I don't like the Tories. They're an odd bunch of people that like, aren't they? But, gotta have a better option than this shit. No part of me supports it. I can't believe they criminalised being rude. Unbelievable. Fucking Scotland.